Drop was the first song where we discovered our sound and what we as Chloe and Hallie wanted to sound like and what was really rooted deep within if we just tried to get it out. I remember we were just in our living room, I was playing guitar, Chloe started playing these really cool 808s and, you know, just started singing out melodies, and Drop came about.
Yeah. My sister and I, what we do sometimes, if we're just going about our day and we'll hear like a word or a word will pop in our head, we'll write it down in our notes because we forget. Yeah. So as I was playing these 808s and Hallie was singing these beautiful melodies, we looked at our list and there was the word drop on it. We were like, what can we do with drop? Yeah. And then we were like, And as words started flowing out, we were like, I know. What we can do is write a song about getting a song stuck in your head, even though you don't want it stuck in your head.
Yeah.
And we personified the song as a human being, because sometimes people are in like those relationships, whether it's friend or a lover, where they don't want to be with the person, but then they do at the same time.
Yeah, and you constantly can't get them out of your head.
Mm-hmm. So everyone thinks the song is about a lover, but it's not. It's about a song you can't get out of your head, but that's Drop. Time stops when your beat drops. Yeah. It's too strong, strong, strong.
It's funny because I think the verses are really, they really sound like it's a person.
Yeah.
Because it's like, baby, I get sick of you. You're that same old tune. Mm-hmm. I don't ever want to hear you again. But then it's like, why are you what I like to skip? I want to be deaf to everything you say, to you, to it. Can I turn my ears off? But then it's like,
when
you realize that it's not a person if you listen closely. So what if the rain falls?
Let's find the goat at the end of the fall. Yeah. I remember writing this in our living room. It was at nighttime. And it was pitch black. Yeah, we were actually scared too. That's happened on several occasions.
Yeah.
Well, we'll write songs at nighttime and it's near our porch door. So it's like open windows.
It's just darkness.
Yeah, and you start like imagining things and you're like, am I seeing shadows? Who's there? So anyway, just had our keyboard and we were playing these simple, you know, notes. Just really simple. And these melodies came and the lyrics came just like that. I kind of don't even remember. It was an outer body experience.
I don't really remember fall that much.
But when we finished writing it and we laid down the vocals really fast because we were scared, we listened to it. We're like, I like this. Let's go to bed. So that was that song.
Yeah. Yeah. And I don't know. It feels very, now when we listen to it, we realize that it feels very, the melodies are like kind of Willy Wonka-ish in a way that it's kind of dreamy, but at the same time spooky.
Mm-hmm. Very whimsical.
Yeah, so that's what we loved about that song, because it makes you feel that way. Like, am I scared or do I like this or so?
But messaging-wise, the song is just always reminding us to stay positive. You know, through our lives, we always try to stay positive. No matter what life throws at you, it's best to just have a good outlook on things.
Yeah.
So it's saying, so what if the sky falls? We'll build a life on the cotton clouds.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. So we'll make the best out of what we get. And that's fall.
Yeah, I think that also comes back to the idea of the kids are all right and everything that, you know, that whole theme is. Because it's just, once again, that same thing of no matter what happens, it's okay. We're going to be okay. And, you know, we'll figure it out. The gun, the gun.